Well, we started out in this old Springdale Library building that was built in the early 20s. It was a sort of a story and a half, like the basement was a half story, and you know, it was partially stuck out of the ground with the first floor being the library part. In the mid-60s, the library moved to Murphy Park, and about that same time, the city of Springdale acquired a collection of Native American and prehistoric materials from a longtime resident named William Guy Howard. We did have, this was pretty active town square here. We actually, there was like a hotel behind this plot of land. There was a hotel and stuff. But in the 1880s, the railroad came through. And so then people just started, and it was east of here. And it came down from Rogers down through here to Fayetteville. And so the businesses just moved over to M Avenue and just kind of lined the streets on either side of the railroad track and the depot. For working in Springdale over these years, I will say that the current activity, the redevelopment of some of the older business buildings on M Avenue has been a major change. The Razorback Greenway has definitely been a big change. And the amount of people that come through because of that, or you know, the different groups in Springdale that are helping to develop the town and bring activity in. Oh, things like with Cash and the Art Forum, who are a lot of art projects here in Springdale that are happening. So, and certainly a lot more diversity in Springdale now than when I first started working here in the 80s.
I'm Angie Albright. And I think one of the things that has made Springdale a little bit different from other cities in the region are a couple of things. There's been a commitment to preservation and some historical thinking, and Springdale leadership and its residents are really proud of not being like every other city in the region.